Today we are doing a PICC dressing. Now remember that these tutorials are simply only informational and you always need to be checking with your agency's policy to make sure you're following the guidelines for your patient population. Now let's get to the lab. Welcome back, my name is Tammy and this is Nurse Minder, and on this channel we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. So we're going to look next at PICC dressings, and the first thing we need to do is to make sure my surface is clean. So we need to cavi wipe the table that we're going to be putting our supplies on. You always want to wear gloves with the cavi wipe because they are toxic. Remove all your patient's belongings to their bedside table and give it a good clean and let it dry. Next, I'm going to gather my supplies and I'll bring them back. So I have all of our supplies. I'm going to go over them for you so you know what to gather. I need a clean pair of gloves to take off the old dressing. I need a mask for me and a mask for my patient because this is a long procedure and they sometimes like to talk a lot with us. So I want to give them a mask so they're not breathing on that area as well. I have a sterile dressing tray. You can do it with or without. I will demonstrate both ways in this video. I have my measuring tape to make sure that I have the correct length of my PICC line, both pre and post. I have a clean 2x2, or sterile 2x2, sorry, so that I can hold my line. If I choose not to use my dressing tray, then I need to still grab a sterile 2x2. My stat lock, which is what this PICC line comes with. You may also find in your facility they have secure caps. Those do not get removed, they stay there. 3 chlorhexidine swabs, my advanced tegaderm, I have alcohol swabs to remove the current stat lock that's there, and of course my sterile gloves. So before we get started, the first thing we're going to do after hand hygiene and patient conversation and explanation is to put on our mask. And then, of course, the mask of our patient as well. And now I'm going to get my tray set up so that it's within arm's reach. So I'm just going ahead and I'm opening my chlorhexidine swabs here. They do have a nice little fold here so you can pull it down without touching it to keep it sterile. I'm going to be using those first. If you were to open up your sterile dressing tray at this point, the items that you would be putting on it would be your tegaderm, your stat lock, and you have sterile dressings in there. So in fact, I'm going to open this in case I need a sterile dressing to help take off. I'm going to put on my clean gloves and then we're going to start to look at this PICC line. With every assessment, we can take a look at the site to make sure that there's no irritation, swelling, edema. We can ask our patient if there's any pain. We're going to do a measurement to make sure. So we're at 13 centimeters, that when we're done, we're also at 13 centimeters. One of the first things I'm going to need are my alcohol swabs and my clean gloves. So we're going to start by taking off this dressing. Now, tegaderms are meant to loosen by pulling sideways on them. And so if you just pull laterally on them, it does lift off the glue. So inside our stat lock is actually a piece of tape, and I'm going to go ahead and grab that out. The rest will stay in there. And if you're using this, it's just to secure the line so that it doesn't move on you. And I'm going to just insert this right here.
The next thing I want to do is actually remove this, and this is still a clean procedure, but I'm going to need alcohol swabs to loosen the glue that's on my mannequin, or on my patient, sorry, so that this lifts up easily. And sometimes you need to lift it and alcohol swab underneath to get that glue to come unstuck. This one's still pretty sticky, so I'm going to do a lot more on top here. And now we see it starting to lift. Now we need to do the other side. So now that we have this all loose and it's able to leave the skin, we're going to open these clamps here. And lift our line up and then remove our dressing. So at this point, now we need to clean it. Now we can still use our clean gloves, or you can choose to put on your sterile gloves at this time if you've put your content in your sterile dressing. So at this time, I'm still using a clean procedure, and I'm now going to do my cleaning. I'm going to grab my first chlorhexidine swab. This is the tip that I want to keep away from my clean gloves. We're going to start with doing broad strokes up and down, back and forth. Make this nice and wide because my dressing is large. And the friction is just as important as the motion. 15 seconds. And then we're going to flip the sponge over and go in a back and forth motion. For again, 15 seconds. And nice broad strokes here. We want to make sure the friction and the chlorhexidine is getting on our patient's skin. So this one is used just for the upper half of the arm. And now we're finished with this one. That can be discarded. We're going to grab our second chlorhexidine swab, again, making sure we're only touching the handle. And now we're going to do the lower half, doing the exact same thing. This may be a place where you want to hold on to your line and lift it up to secure it. So we're going to start up and down, big broad strokes. Again, we do this for 15 seconds. There's a bit of tape residue here. Then we're going to flip it over and go in the opposite direction. For 15 seconds. Now the final chlorhexidine swab is for underneath the line. So here's where I'm going to use my sterile 2x2 to support the line so I don't accidentally pull it out and clean underneath. And then I'm going to flip it over and clean on top. Make sure you get nice in those areas here where it might be a bit gunky. And I can lift off my gauze and clean the rest of the line. We're going to let that dry, and this might take 2 minutes to dry. So this is a good time to get sterile if you're not already. Sterile tray over now, and we're going to return to our patient. So I brought my sterile field over so you can see a little bit more closely related to the PICC dressing. Now at this point in time, we want to put our skin prep on, and this is just going to go around the entire, everything is dry now, so we're going to just put skin prep around the entire thing. And remember, this is sterile, it came in my sterile kit. So this is going to get tacky, and you'll know that it's ready to go because my gloves are starting to stick together, so the tackiness is there. So we're going to take our stat lock first, arrows pointed towards the insertion site, and we're going to slip this in and secure this. Now just to remind you that these are sterile gloves, so I can touch the sterile field in which I've cleaned and am working in. Close off these clamps. Close off these clamps. And secure. now my PICC line is secure. I'm going to take my tegaderm, and we want this insertion site to have a nice window of tegaderm around it. So we're going to put this loosely over top so that it's about in the center if we can. I'm just going to move my line over a bit. There we go. And then smooth down our edges. I can take off this holding tape now and remove the film of my tegaderm.
We still have two tapes left to apply. We have the large secure tape and then the date tape. When working with the IV Advanced Tegaderm, your large secure tape will then be placed on top of your original dressing such that the U's will line up for the opening and it will secure your catheter in place. The date tape is then filled out and applied along the white border of your dressing. If in your facility you are using a different dressing, you may be placing the large secure tape underneath the IV catheter lines to secure it with the U-shape pointing up. And the dressing date tape may in fact be used on top of those lines to further secure. Last but not least, we're going to redo our measurement to ensure post-dressing measurement is the same as our pre-dressing measurement.
There you have it, your PICC dressing all taken care of. Now make sure you're always gathering your supplies, cleaning that station before you start, and you're getting your patient's consent if possible. Until next time, make it a great day.